Distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Government of Indonesia, I would like to thank for all the organizers who organizing this meeting, UN Finance Minister meeting, with the topic of financing for development in the era of COVID-19 and beyond. As we are all aware that COVID-19 pandemic has caused unprecedented challenge, multidimensional crisis for all countries in the world, and that create an extraordinary challenge which is cannot be responded with business as usual. The pandemic also a true test for the global cooperation and solidarity in how we are going to defeat and cope with that, and especially also in recovering the economy. All countries in the world now struggle to recover and building back their economies. Many countries have put forward the safety of their people in preventing and also countering the spread of the COVID-19. They also put forward some policy which is really important to save the lives and livelihood while maintaining the walk a thin line of narrowing their own fiscal burden with a higher debt burden. Indonesia also dealing with this pandemic in a very challenging way. The government responding by launching the National Economic Recovery Program, which is contained of mostly supporting the livelihood and the life of the people, while also at the same time focusing on addressing the pandemic COVID-19. I would like to congratulate all the participants today that in the previous session, which discussing fruitfully the communication challenge and the policy challenge, which is dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic. The process has brought member states, representative, as well as other relevant stakeholders together to work and try to find urgent and innovative solution to this COVID-19 emergency and to build back the economy better. We realize that there is no silver bullet in dealing with the current crisis. The menu policy option which is discussed on a previous discussion, also useful for each country to learn from each other, from how we design the health preparedness and emergency response, up to the social safety net, in terms of how we design and collect the data and design the right targeting, as well as support for the business, especially small and medium enterprises. I would like to point out several policy options that are really important for building the recovery back better. First, since this pandemic must be slowed down in all countries, global cooperation becoming very, very important, especially in testing and tracing system to mitigate the spread of the virus and in providing affordable access to vaccine for all, which is important because one country setback is going to be also a setback for the others, given the high interconnectedness of the global economy. Second, given the fiscal space is going to be threatened and pressured with this COVID-19, there is real important for the cooperation globally in addressing a narrowing fiscal burden. How we are going to prioritize policy while at the same time creating a global cooperation which helps country to ease the burden to avoid a downward spiral credit rating that also caused a debt tsunami. A debt relief, especially for the low-income country, should aim at providing fiscal space which is also supporting the country to address the most priority needed for the country to bring their country back to the recovery, both in the health and economic and social sector. Third, the global recovery must be aligned with the 2030 SDG agenda. and also Paris Agreement on Climate Change. We can design the recovery program, which is putting the element of SDG in our policy design. For example, our social safety net in Indonesia designed in order for us to be able to address the issue of financial inclusion and gender equality. This is very critical for us to be able to continue pursue the SDG goal, which is at the same time also designing the recovery. We also can support the priority policy for the green financing in order for us to be able to support the project that can address the issue of climate change. These are all require a global cooperation, both on the financing side as well as on the policy coordination. The current crisis has taught us that we need to even stronger and also coordinate better in order for us to be able to overcome this toughest challenge created by COVID-19. Global recovery is on the line. We must act together as global recovery is in the best interest for every country, every business, and every multilateral forum. In this context, Indonesia stands ready to work together with all our global partners to achieve the common objective. I wish you all a success in your combined effort to respond to this challenging global pandemic COVID-19. And I wish you all the best luck. Thank you.